Hello friends, my name is Smita Tolani and I am from St. Vincent Paloti College of Engineering and Technology, Nagpur. In FDP 201, the open educational resource that we are creating, in this lesson we are going to cover the present status and conclusion for solar energy conversion systems. So the first question comes, why you go for solar? Because it is dependable, it is a secure investment for anybody. Solar energy is replenishable. You can say bye-bye to electricity bills, and you should know that 1 hour of sunshine gives us 1 year of power for the entire globe. It is a very low maintenance, less of a hassle. You can start repeating benefits from day one. Perfect for power production in remote areas. These are some of the advantages why, because of which we should go for solar. The facts that you should know about solar energy and its conversion is that the energy radiated by sun in 1 second is more than what we have been able to utilize since the beginning of time. And you should know that even on an overcast and cloudy places such as Cherrapunji, it receives around at least an hour of sunlight every day all throughout the year. Did you know that any sunny location on average receives at least around 5.5 hours of sunlight per day all the year around? 1 kilowatt of energy per hour, or of per electricity per hour, is equals to the electricity required to run a 100 watt light bulb for a period of 10 hours. And a kilowatt peak solar system produces approximately 750 kilowatts every year, even in a cloudy place. And even on overcast days, a typical solar module can produce around 10 to 20% of electricity it produces in sunny conditions. The current status of solar energy and its conversion in India is that solar power in India is the fastest producing and developing industry. The country's solar capacity of installation has reached 26 gigawatts as of 30th September 2018. Government is on its way to receiving 175 gigawatts target for installed renewable energy capacity by 2022. India attains global 4th and 6th position in the global wind and solar power installed capacity. Here is a reflection spot. You think over it for 5 minutes or maybe 2 minutes that what is the present status of solar energy generation in India? What are the various government policies to promote solar energy use? Give it a thought for 2 minutes. Okay, so these are some of the statistics that are available with us. You can see that under the Indian government sanctioned solar master plan, there are nearly some cities which have been selected to become the part of solar cities project for the Indian years to come. And the cities include New Delhi, Amritsar, Gurgaon, Chandigarh, Faridabad and Agra. You can see over here, these are nothing but the top 10 solar states which cumulative installations have been attained. And India has cumulative installed power capacity mix percentage of nearly wind is 9.87%, solar is 6.59%, biopower is 2.52%, and small hydro is 1.30%. These are certain central and state government solar policies, which includes National Solar Mission, renamed Jawaharlal Nehru National Solar Mission, National Mission for Enhanced Energy Efficiency, National Mission on Sustainable Habitat, National Water Mission, National Mission for Sustaining the Himalayan Ecosystem, National Mission for a Green India, National Mission for Sustainable Agriculture, National Mission on Strategic Knowledge for Climate Change. These are some of the central and state government solar policies that have been adopted. Solar is the new smart. We have to go solar, go green and go smarter. The references for this particular open educational resource are as follows. I hope these resources will help you get some understanding of what are the current situations and scenarios of solar energy conversion and its uses in our country. Thank you.